Hi friends, welcome back. After looking into how a NOT gate can be implemented electronically through a transistor, now let us see what next we can implement and the next simple gate we can implement is a NAND gate. So the NAND operation is shown in this truth table that only when both inputs are 1, output is going to be 0. For other cases, it will be a 1. So this we ensure through this inverter action, that is the NOT gate action. We had seen this circuit as a NOT operation. So when the input is high, output is low. In the input is low, output is high. That's what we had seen, and somehow if we can make this point low, then this point gets high. So to make it high here, we need a low here. To make this a low, the simplest way is pull down this voltage down to a low value so that the transistor gets into cutoff. So pulling down, so we need a pulling action, so the current has to be pulled out in this direction. So we use a diode. The two diodes are used in this case. So what is it going to do? Say, let us consider this truth table when they applied here. So when A is low, yes, because of this current can flow. When B is low, yes, because of this current can flow. So if A is low, current will flow through diode to A down, and if B is low, the current will flow through diode and B down. So any one of them is low, there will be a current flowing outwards. That makes no current available to flow in this direction. Therefore, this gets off. So, let's look more detail. Say both are low. Therefore, this diode is conducting. This diode is also conducting. So, the current is draining out of this circuit, and hence this point voltage will go low and no current is available to flow through base emitter, and hence the transistor gets into cutoff. And if the transistor gets into cutoff, there won't be any collector current, and no collector current means the voltage drop across RC will be zero, and hence the total VCC will be available at VO. So full voltage, that's a maximum voltage is available. So we can say, yes, the output is high. Output is high means we say, yes, it is on 1. Okay, let's get to second condition. A is 0, B is 1. So B is 1, that means this current will not be flowing. But since A is 0, this current will be flowing, and since this current is flowing, then the current which is flowing through RB is drained out through this diode, and hence no current is available for base emitter junction to get this into saturation, and hence this will continue to be in cutoff. And if this is cutoff, the output will be high. Therefore, VO will be 1. Third case is A is 1. So if A is 1, this diode gets reverse biased, so doesn't conduct. But B is 0, but therefore the current which is flowing through RB is drained out through this diode, and the current is no more available for the base emitter junction, and hence the transistor continues to be in cutoff region, and hence output continues to be 1. When both are 1, neither this diode can conduct nor this diode can conduct. So when both are 1, is a special case, so there won't be current in this, there won't be current in this, so no current drains out of this circuit, and hence whatever current is there which is flowing from VCC to ground through RB has to flow through the base emitter junction, and there is base current, and since there is base current which can drive the transistor into saturation, therefore the IC saturation will flow through the collector and the transistor is on, and hence the output will be a saturation voltage which is a very small value, and that can be considered as a low. So for 00 we get a high, for 01 we get a high, for 10 we get a high, for 11 we get a low. So that's what this truth table talks of, and this truth table is exactly same as this, and hence we can call this circuit as a NAND gate. Okay, to implement this NAND gate, what all required? We require a diode, we require a transistor. So this whole logical system is derived out of using diode and transistor, so we call this diode transistor logic, or in short we call it a DTL circuit. DTL circuit is one which can provide Boolean operations using diodes and transistors. So this is a DTL circuit for NAND gate. Now how to get a AND gate? Yes, definitely NOT of NOT is back. So if A is 0, then A bar is 1 and its complement gets back to 0. Therefore, whatever is A, if it is complemented two times, we get back to the same one. So what is required? The NAND we had got from complementing AND operation. So if you complement this again, then yes, it is going to be AND operation. So to complement it again, then what we can do is use another inverting circuit. So this output is NAND operation, and this is our simple NOT gate, and NAND is inverted again. So what is NAND? VO was A and B bar, and this VO1 is same as VO bar, which is A and B bar was VO, another bar, so that's two bars is same as our original thing, so that is A and B. So by using one more NOT gate, a NAND gate can be converted back into a AND gate. So there are many such options for making this work. Okay, many more things to come in further sessions. So till then, take care, see you, bye.